दिस इज वन्ना विद वार्म ग्रीटिंग्स. इट गिव्स मी अ ग्रेट प्लेजर टू एक्सटेंड अ वार्म वेलकम ऑफ ऑल ऑफ यू ऑन द बिहाफ ऑफ सीन्स वेलफेयर फाउंडेशन. टुडे वी आर कंडक्टिंग अ वेबिनार ऑन फाइनेंशियल इंजीनियरिंग. फाइनेंशियल इंजीनियरिंग इज अ न्यू कॉन्सेप्ट. इट इज अ मल्टी डिसिप्लिनरी फील्ड इन्वॉल्विंग फाइनेंशियल थ्योरी, मेथड्स ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग, टूल्स ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स एंड द प्रैक्टिस ऑफ प्रोग्रामिंग. It has also been defined as the application of technical methods, especially from the mathematical finance and computational finance in the practice of finance. For the better understanding of the financial engineering, we have invited a special guest. She is work as a full-time professor at University of Engineering and Management, Jaipur, India. She is a permanent member of All India Commerce Association. She has 15 years of experience in teaching, research, administration, training and consultancy. She has been awarded the best teacher award for many years. At Pan India level, she is the only professor chosen for the technical program committee for 2021, the 9th International Conference on Business Management and Governance, ICBMG 2021. She is advisory committee member of World Research Society. She is also the member of Digi Saksham. She has been invited as a chairperson for many international conferences that are happening in virtually. With warm greetings, we are welcoming our special guest, Professor Dr. Lata Rani. Welcome, ma'am.
Thank you so much, Vandana, for such a nice introduction. First and foremost, I extend a warm welcome and a warm greetings from my heartfelt thanks with a gratitude that I have been invited by Digi Saksham. So yes, we are going to talk about financial engineering. I'm working as a professor in School of Management, University of Engineering and Management, Jaipur branch. I will be talking about introduction to financial engineering. I'll be discussing meaning and definitions of this term. I'll be explaining the process of financial engineering as to how it is being done, different examples of financial engineering, what are the different tools that are being exercised by financial engineers. Along with it, I'll be talking about applications of financial engineering, advantages, merits of financial engineering, what is the role of financial engineering in derivative, and how the team of financial engineering works. At the last, I would be concluding my session with the inputs that I have collected from different resources in terms of research paper and database. Let us start. When we talk about financial engineering, in brief, it is a concept, it is a discipline, it is a subject. Rather now, it is a degree also, whereby different financial tools and techniques are used by companies to improve resource effectiveness. When I use this term resource effectiveness, I mean the resources of constrained nature, which may be your financial resources, which is always a limiting factor, which is always a constraint to one's life, to one's business, towards any venture. So this is basically how you are exploring, how you are evaluating different financial tools to improve resource effectiveness. And believe you me, it is not only challenging but interesting, because we are going to combine different disciplines into this stream, financial engineering. It is a combination of different subjects. These subjects may range from finance to economics. These subjects may range from quantitative techniques to computer science. These subjects may be in terms of computational finance, as Vanda has elaborated a brief of financial engineering. So all those tools and techniques are part and parcel of different subjects. So what is financial engineering? Financial engineering involves utilization of mathematical techniques in solving financial problems. This process uses tools and knowledge from the subject, from the disciplines of economics, statistics, applied mathematics, computer science, information technology, where we do require coding. So when we talk about financial problems, financial constraints, and providing the solution of the same, this is basically, we are referring it as financial engineering. So is it like an engineer of BTech nature that are taking charge of financial engineering? Certainly those engineers, if they convert their degree into financial metrics, into a financial modeling, then they can also serve as financial engineers. Financial engineering create, design, and implement new financial models and processes in order to find out solution for problems. So they always seek different financial opportunities. They prepare modeling. Whenever we look at any software which is making a calculation easy, like a machine is what? Making you conveniently doing the things easy for you. We are living in a machine era, and we are looking after different innovations in terms of IoT, machine learning. And I'm proudly saying that our university has courses which are providing all these new innovations in terms of BTech degree. So when we talk about innovations, when we talk about Internet of Things, when we talk about machine learning, basically they are making calculations easy. So portfolios are constructed at a worldwide level. Look at the economics. When you have simple question in your mind, that if we are printing notes of our country on our own, why not to print many notes so that there should be everybody should be flooded with the money? I mean, a very simple question may be coming in the minds of students. Agar hamare paas power hai, hum note chhaap sakte hain, RBI note chhaap raha hai, to zyada hi chhaap dena, sabki salary badh jaye, sabki taxation badh jaye. So money jitni zyada market mein hogi utni use ho jayegi. It is a basic demand and supply. So why what is the basic reason as to why there is a constraint in printing those notes? So those constraints are evaluated from the world level market. When we look at the inflation rate, particular commodity price is rising up. So that is basically a calculation. How that calculation is possible? Believe you me, when we talk about these calculations, permutation, combination, there are softwares which are making this possible. How it is possible to collaborate the data of 250,000 companies into a one index, and that index is moving in terms of up and down. So it is basically permutation and combination which are being solved with the help of formulas. All those financial formulas are part of financial engineering. What are the different factors which are affecting financial engineering? Basically, two factors. One is internal, another is external. When I say external, I mean environmental. In environmental, we may consider it as PEST, political factors, economic factors, social factors, technological factors. So all these are external. Economy is influenced, our market is influenced by political news many a times. Economic news in terms of inflation, rise in prices, many a times. So environmental and internal factors are major factors which are affecting. Look at the definition. So here it is very important to quote a definition of John Finnerty. Financial engineering involves the design, the development, and innovation, that is implementation of innovative financial instruments and processes, and the formulation of creative solutions to problems in finance. In order to understand this definition, let me take you towards a simple, lucid manner as a layman jargon. We all are existing on a financial scale. Somewhere you guys are using cash to make a transaction possible. Somewhere you are making a budget to make the transaction possible. Somewhere you are connecting yourself to the credit card. So you look at the financial products surrounding and you are using it every day. It would not be shocking if I tell you that you would be using many times in a day. So somewhere when we look at the business of conglomerate nature, which are larger than enough, where different companies are operating as a parents and subsidiary companies, where business has no limit, businesses have become borderless business, So they have huge transactions. So they do exist on a financial scale. Now, existing on a financial scale is measured from low to high. Low means you're using a very limited financial resources. Maybe like a person like me is using a cash payment more oftenly than relying on Google Pay, Paytm. Maybe people like you would be using it as Google Paytm or credit card or insurance to make the payments, right? So on the financial scales, it may be low to high. So low to high is basically on the basis of needs of person, needs of business. So how financial engineering is helping you in terms of developing the tools, developing the content of financial instruments. So Investopedia explained financial engineers use various mathematical tools in order to create new investment strategies. Very important. So all these financial products are revised, updated, upgraded on the basis of strategies that are pertaining to investment. Stock market was existing in 1980s also, but it is existing now also. Look at the phenomena that people know. There is a market, there is a share, there is a company, there is a return. So when we talk about financial products, they have been campaigned, they have been made aware in such a manner that the new products are created by financial engineering, and all those financial engineers work in a collaborative manner to make economy run. To make economy run means that liquidity position of the country is not in danger. When we are conducting this webinar virtually, remembering the back-end story of COVID-19 and somewhere now news are coming of black fungus, so somewhere we are facing this pandemic, and by virtue of this, number of businesses are stuck. Businesses like hospitality sector is in stuck. Nobody is going moving out. Nobody is having a meal outside. Nobody is availing the services of hotel. So somewhere those sectors may face danger of liquidity. So products are created in such a manner that liquidity of the country is ensured, that it is moving. Sometimes it is moving towards highest peak, and sometimes it can come into low peak. So we may refer these two markets as bullish market and bearish market. So four concepts you need to understand: that everyone is existing on a financial maturity. There is a scale. Even a student of class 10th is using that scale. If your ward, you yourself are making online purchase, you are referring one product, you are making a payment, you are existing on a financial scale maturity. So every one of us are existing on a scale. Now, scale may vary from low to high. So we have to ensure that we must improve. As a business, we must improve on the financial maturity. Improving means, earlier I was using cash system. Now instead of cash, let's focus on to online payment, digital banking, digital money transfer, or NEFT, IMPS, or placing the order and making the payment through the apps. So all these are the financial products which would increase your efficiency. So is it necessary to increase the efficiency as a business? Yes. Increasing financial maturity improves the resource effectiveness, which I was referring as a first slide. So you all can do financial engineering. Financial engineering is combination of different forces to ensure that you know the financial problem, you develop the financial solutions, you implement that solution. So it is basically your financial constraints and problems are identified, evaluated, solved, controlled, and revised. All these five are basically part of the process. Yes, when you are involved with the financial engineering, remember that you should keep these five points in your mind. So in order to ensure that you wanted to have some planning in terms of finance, first of all, you just check out what is your net worth. By net worth, I mean the net worth of the company, or salary of a salaried person or profit of a business class. So net worth is evaluated from different angles. So it is the earning position of the person. So net worth is how you are going to save it. So it is basically a function of demand and supply, where your income is equal to consumption plus saving. So this S is your net worth, saving. Second, what are your goals to make investment? Goals may be very short term, like in a short term, I need, like my daughter is saying, I need a Miko. Okay, what is Miko? It is a mama robot. So short term, I just need it within these 4 months. So I said, okay, just try to save your money, whatever I'm giving you. So goal can be short term, goal can be medium term, goal can be long term. So when we talk about goals, it depends upon time horizon. So you may have a goal of tax saving, which is just applicable to 1 year. You may have a goal of going outside as a foreign vacation, or educating people, or educating your kids, marrying your kids, retirement plans. So how your goals are being changed? What are your goals? You have to keep that thing in your mind. Third is, how much money do I need and when? Plan it out for down 5 years, how much money do you need? Remember when I was talking about certain schemes in terms of FDs, in terms of recurring deposits, in terms of systematic investment plans, as to you have to chart out the things which you may require down the 5 years. So 5 year planning must be done in order to ensure that your expenditures are well planned and budget has already been allocated. So your money may be like, if you have some plans down the 5 years, your EMIs are going on, you have to settle down your principal payment, write it down on that paper. When you will arriving on all expected expenditure, when you will be calculating all probable budgeting figures, then whatsoever is needed, you will plan it accordingly. Your investment will be according to your horizon. How much risk I can take? Yes, there are three types of risk takers. One is very conservative. No, I don't want to take any kind of risk. So again, financial engineer has a product for such people. Like, you invest in gilt-edged securities, you invest in government securities. So on the basis of risk proportion, risk is basically called beta in finance language. That is part of your risk. So risk may be moderate, risk may be aggressive. So on the basis of risk, you have to ensure that you are putting out your money. And last, very important question, where should I invest? Normally we come across with a lecture like this. We generally ask, okay, what is the suitable option right now in during this pandemic? Many of you would be coming across with this question very oftenly. Ab kya sahi time hai? Kis mein invest karna chahiye? So take the advices of people or listen to news, read out business news, and then accordingly you think, is equity option favorable for you, debt option favorable for you, or very safe like gold bond, sovereign gold bond? So you choose the financial products where you wanted to invest.
Good morning, ma'am.
Morning.
Ma'am, will it be good to right now to invest in corporate bond debt fund?
When we talk about corporate bond, remember that this is the time when we look forward for different investments. And as an investor, like I mentioned, if you are an investor which is of conservative nature, then you should wait for some time because market is highly interested. If you are an aggressive investor, definitely corporate bonds are a good option to invest. But make sure that you know their fundamental and technical analysis, because if that stock is giving a return at least for a month or 3 months, then accordingly you can go for this. So yes, if you are a moderate and aggressive investor, you should invest those. Otherwise, there is a gold bond also which is being lined up in 3 years back. So yes, you can.
Thank you, ma'am.
So yes, financial engineering, we have discussed in detail. It is finance plus engineering. Like I told you, there are certain disciplines which are involved, which are developing financial products, financial instruments in order to resolve financial problems, right? So how come this permutation combination comes? Basically, we talk about finance and economics in this course, right? Financial engineering is an application of mathematics and statistics to study financial markets using sophisticated computer science techniques. So when I use this computer science technique, I mean coding, I mean machine learning, I mean Internet of Things. So when we talk about this financial engineering, it is the application of different disciplines coming all together to resolve or to put forward a solution of financial problems. So financial engineering at the last is a discipline which deals with the creation of new and improved financial products through innovative design or repackaging of existing financial instruments. So in a layman, if I need to explain you, these are those products which make your risk mitigated, which make your risk minimized, through which these are those applications onto which risk and return calculations are trade-off, are calculated, are provided. So financial engineering do exist in security analysis, portfolio management, hedging techniques, swapping, right? So when we talk about Indian financial market, their products, financial instruments, financial institutions, all those are very much integral part of financial engineering. So financial engineering and innovations are seen in different financial products. So what are those financial products? They may be debt-oriented schemes of mutual funds. Remember, when mutual funds have started, it was simply a pool of fund by the pool manager to be allocated in a common objective. Debt-oriented schemes of mutual funds, interest rate futures, swaps, currency swaps, floating rate bonds, money market mutual funds, all these products are part of financial products. In a simple language, I'll be explaining this in detail in the later on slides. Process of financial engineering. The process is very important. How do financial engineers work? What are the basic steps which they take into consideration? So these steps which I'm going to explain you now are sequential steps. They are going to work one by one, and once one is over, they move forward for second one. Look at this picture and it would be very clear. First of all, you have to identify a need. So any financial product starts with a financial need. Like I told you, what is my goal to make an investment? What is my purpose of making an investment? So same way, if individual is thinking in like this manner, institutions, businesses, conglomerates, hybrid firms, and so many entities at the global platform exist because of this. So first of all, we have to identify a need platform. We have to ensure that we know what is the goal, what is the need. Second, initial sketch of product. Just like when we talk about any product that you can touch upon, that product is a contribution given by R&D department, research and development department. Look at the surrounding products which are innovative and you are using, how Apple is marketing its product, how come this innovation is coming in the electronic gadgets so oftenly, that those companies are making a self-competition with them. So how come i10, i11, i12? So they are not competing with anyone, rather they are having self-competition spirit. Thanks to R&D department who are looking after certain changes that are being done from i10 to i11, i11 to i12. Maybe a change of your RAM, camera, settings, right? So in those manners, you have to initially sketch a product. Financial product will be initially drafted. Remember that this financial product is not a one-hand job and it is not a one-time job. It will be based on number of draftings, redrafting, and then making it as a conclusion. So what we look at is the financial product. Look at the insurance policy and just keep that thing in your mind. You will be understanding all these points. आपके पास एक इंश्योरेंस एजेंट आता है एंड दे आर एक्सप्लेनिंग यू वन पॉलिसी कि सर दिस पॉलिसी दीज फीचर्स आई विल नॉट बी टेकिंग एनी नेम यू जस्ट बिकॉज़ आई एम नॉट एंडोर्सिंग एनी स्कीम हियर विद सो आई एम स्पीकिंग ऑल ऑफ दिस इन माय पर्सनल कैपेसिटी सो एनी पॉलिसी एंड दे आर एक्सप्लेनिंग यू सो दे आर एक्सप्लेनिंग फीचर वन बाय वन कि सर दिस पॉलिसी this much premium, this much insurance, and this much risk coverage, this much benefit. So all of these things are designed, redesigned, drafted, redrafted many a times. So what you look at a simple product, what you look at a sovereign gold bond, any application form, companies are doing a lot more to launch that product, maybe in form of IPO, maybe in form of any share, FPO. So initial sketch of product is drafted. Then complex model building exercise. Now, why I use this word complex? Because financial engineering is as much interesting as much challenging. So complex is you have to make the calculation in such a manner whereby if a person is getting this, they should be benefited as well as companies have to take the cost. I remember when I came across with a credit card, I thought, what company will be earning out of it? Like company is giving credit card, take the credit card, buy all the products, make a shopping and make us payment after 45 days, 52 days. Different companies have different maturity time period. And if you will be failing, then we will be taking 1.5% interest or 2% per month. So this 2%, 1.5% is basically when you are defaulting the payment. So when I came across with this scheme, I just thought and thought and thought. I gave a 14 days thought provoking process as to what credit company, card companies will be benefited out of it. Because it is only a benefit of a customer. Yeah, I will buy a product of rupees 1000. I have 52 days to make that payment. So 1000 rupees to be paid after 50 days, after 45 days. Later on, by collecting the certain evidences or reading out research papers or reading out certain things, I came to know that credit card companies are also earning out of it. So remember, financial products are win-win situations. So that's why it is one of the complex models, to make it as win-win. So if you are negotiating a product with a seller, okay, I will make you payment of 400 rupees. If he is demanding 500, still he will earn any margin from 400 also. So same way, financial products, financial services are catered in such a manner that both, that is company as well as client, as well as customer, is in the win-win position. Then you test that product. Testing means you are running a coding, machine learning applications. You have to run it. You have to test it in order to deliver it. So programs are run in such a manner. Look at the software called CMIE, Center of Monitoring Indian Economy Progress. They are storing lots of data in terms of employment, in terms of inflation, in terms of buyback, in terms of dividend. I mean, the company pertaining information, they are existing in economy, you will easily get that data from CMIE. And once that data is processed, there are lots of softwares, SPSS, eViews. So somewhere they are making your calculation easy as to what you want to do. But those calculations are made possible with the help of softwares, with the help of coding, with the help of programs. So those programs are tested. Then perfect product on the basis of exercise. Once testing is done successfully, that product is coming in the category of perfect product. Then accordingly, you launch that in terms of pricing. What should be the price of this product? So if any policy is coming to you, they are explaining you all the features, they are explaining you all the advantages. Ultimately, that has a cost. That has a price. So pricing of the product is basically discussed at a different level. Let's take one example of IPO, initial public offering, or FPO, follow-up public offering, or simple language mein, share issue. In that, they are following BB process, book building. So book building process is basically holding out meetings, taking out prices, making it as an averaging. So pricing and restructuring is done in order to ensure the product price is delivered at its best. So pricing and restructuring is basically the decision factors leviable on the cost of that product, cost of that instrument. Test marketing. So now you will be doing it in the form of test marketing, how that product will be marketed, how that product will be launched. what would be the guidelines to launch it? Certain financial products come with a date tagline where they have open date as well as close date. So you need to ensure once all these steps are done, we go ahead with the launching of the product. So we launch the product, you see the schemes available in the banks, in the insurance sector, in the hedging sector, in the stock market sector. All those schemes are basically part of financial engineering. So we are involved. Even if you open a bank account with a bank, this is also a part of financial engineering. As to what account, what features, what benefits, what interest, all this is basically part and parcel of financial engineering. These are the examples which I'm going to explain one by one. Voting shares. These are those shares whereby securities are issued where voting rights are not being given. So equity and preference, when we talk about this, we always say equity share class is a risky class. They are risky because they have a right to vote. If a company is earning a profit, company wants to declare dividend, and then they get the dividend distribution. And if company does not, then accordingly they will not get. And if company has a profit, but that profit is distributed among debenture holders and preference shareholders, and nothing is left in the hands of company, then remember, equity shareholders are not going to get even a single penny. So in this way, they are risky class. Employee stock option plan, it is ESOP. So let our employees be given a share of our company so that they feel they are part and parcel of the management. So ABB company has tried out this scheme, ESOP. They have given their shares to their employees, and this works as a miracle. I remember when I was discussing this ESOP one fine day with my students, there was a case study also, Uttar Pradesh Transportation Corporation. In that, basically, there was a juggle between private buses and public buses. Public routed buses are never being run on the same frequency, on the same speed as private buses. When the then CM, that is Mayawati ji, came to know that public buses nahi chal rahi hai, private bahut frequency se chal rahi hai, and in the evening they are sharing the profit, they have kept this as a policy. Okay, fine, whatsoever you will be earning, you will be given a certain percentage of profit of this. So employee feel motivated when they are getting the share of their own company. They are true brand ambassador of the company. You do 10 things good to your employees, they will speak 100 times to 1,000 people. And this is nothing but a ESOP. So they belong, that they create belongingness towards the company. So ESOP is another option where you could give it as a employee's stock out option or sweat equity. Sweat equity share, where you are making your existing shareholders happy. So it is sweat equity. You are offering shares to existing shareholders first. You give them time. They may accept, they may reject. And then later on, you launch this offer to the public. So by this way, you are making your existing shareholders happy one. Zero coupon bonds. They are issued and redeemed at par. These bonds are not carrying any interest, still they are workable, right? Dual currency bonds, floating rate bonds. So these are certain financial products whereby the amount is denoted in dollars. Interest is denoted in Indian rupees. So dual currency bonds, they have a speciality. The principal amount is in US dollar, whereas interest amount is in INR rupees. These kinds of bonds can be issued to NRIs so that they can have a benefit as a designation or beneficiary in India, and amount is remitted to designated beneficiary in India. These kinds of bonds are really issued in order to make sure that NRIs are part and parcel of their investment. So now investment is not confined to a particular country. Rather, everyone is involved with the global investment somewhere or the other. We could take the example of year 2008, where Adani Power has issued dual currency bond amounting to rupees dollar. Like I mentioned, amount of principal is expressed in dollar, whereas interest is expressed in INR rupees. So they have issued this to give a finance to Mundra Power projects. Dual rate loans, in the same manner, fixed rate of interest is charged to borrowers up to prefixed period, and then after it is linked to benchmark rate. So recently, HDFC Bank has issued dual rate loans, whereby up to some extent, this kind of interest will be charged, and later on, this kind of interest. So when you are making the payment slowly and gradually, your interest rate is reduced. And there is also a clause which is involved in every financial instrument. If you are availing loan and you pay before time, somewhere you are giving a benefit of interest reduction. So those kinds of financial instruments are dual rate loans. So these are the applications. Once you do the course of financial engineering, once you study this in terms of bachelor's or master's, you could place assure your job in investment banking, corporate strategic planning, risk management, primary and derivative, financial information system, portfolio management, security trading, like I mentioned earlier.
Ma'am, good morning, ma'am. Ma'am, how coding can be used in this kind of financial subject? How coding?
When we talk about coding, let me show you one slide and accordingly I'll explain you. Look at this slide. We are supposed to calculate certain return on investment. So what we are basically doing it is a coding. So how your formulas, if you are calculating a particular formula on Excel sheet, on SPSS, that is backed by coding, that is backed by this formula. So in a runway, you have to take help of Python, you have to take help of machine learning, Internet of Things, to make this as a possible. So nowadays, there are financial calculators which are available very easily. Look at those financial calculators, they are backed by coding.
And what is the difference between traditional financial management and financial engineering? Because traditionally, we are using mathematics also in capital busting, cost of capital.
Very good question, very good question. When we talk about traditional financing, remember that we are using limited financial management techniques. So yes, we are studying. We are not studying the application part. In financial engineering, you are studying a financial application part along with the practicality. So traditional financial management is a theoretical where the concepts are being cleared. What is fundamental analysis? What is technical analysis? So more focus is on theoretical, and if practical is there, then that is made sure that they are not teaching you how to derive a particular Python. So even if you know that this is a risk, this is a return, this is a cumulative return, this is the average return, so somewhere you know the formula, right? So you will be applying those formulas to a particular company, but how to make that formula is basically a cup of job by financial engineers.
Ma'am, how to use this kind of coding? I think this is very difficult to learn this coding.
No, it's not difficult when there is a course and when you will be giving your time in a due time, this is taught. So this is not at all difficult. Like I told you, we initially, I remember 10 or 15 years back, people, students were scared from mathematics, and now they are taking up mathematics in a frequent way. So yes,
because I know BTech student, CA student, they can learn in easy way. Yes. Because a lot of courses, MBA, financial engineering, the BTEC students are doing this kind of course. But yes, for the BBA, BCom students, very difficult to learn this one.
No, it is difficult. It is challenging. I do agree on to this point. But it is not that tough. When you come across with the Python theorems, now you can learn it. It may be requiring more challenge, more time, more patience, but it will be learned. There is as such, when we compare the BCom and BTech students, certainly that difference will be there. During those 4 years, they are learning all this. Now, even when I refer it to my university, they have adopted a curriculum in such a manner where all these terms are revised, all syllabuses are revised. So now students are learning onto this IoT, So BTech student will definitely do it, perform this job very easily. But I don't mean that BBA, BCom student, MBA, MCom student cannot learn it. Definitely, it is a patience exercise. Just I wanted to show you this. You come across with this also in terms of market upwards, market downwards. So somewhere all those technical charts calculations are making this possible. But remember that every high or every low is being based on the software. So that software is a part of financial software, financial product, and financial products are developed by financial engineers.
Thank you, ma'am, for this wonderful session.
Thank you so much. It is my delighted talk, and I'm feeling expressing my heartfelt thanks to SEMS Association to make me a proud member of your association. This association is working not for profit organization. It is working for weaker section to be uplifted, and we all are collaboratively helping for women empowerment. We all are working for student fraternity to take up sessions in a meanwhile regular intervals. Thank you, Atul. Thank you, Vanna. So kind.